imagine if we could treat mental health rather than stigmatize it. It will cover access to life-saving drugs. It will cover access to life-improving medications, because life is about more than just surviving. Thirdly, this care and treatment must be affordable, accessible, and universal. Without these, Ohioans' health will continue to be at risk. I know this bill is likely to face opposition, in opposition of our lifetime, but it's time. However, I would like to take the chance to dispel a few misconceptions about health insurance and the Ohio Health Security Act. There's a fear that having statewide health insurance will cause businesses to leave the state. However, an econometric study by the California Nurses Association showed that a single-payer system will create jobs, mostly in retail and manufacturing. It reduces liability in auto insurance costs. It reduces workers' compensation costs. It will save Ohio and Ohioans money and build a stronger future for businesses in Ohio and our citizens. The majority of Ohioans will not seek an increase in their taxes and will, in fact, save money under the Ohio Health Security Act. The plan will be funded by payroll taxes paid by employers, a gross receipts tax paid by businesses, a 6.2% tax in excess of the amount subject to the Social Security payroll tax, and a 5% tax on income over $200,000. The act will allow us to collect together state and federal health care support and the money private businesses are already spending on health insurance to provide health care to their employees and to the state. Companies that already provide insurance, in fact, are likely to see their insurance costs decrease. Without co-payments, deductibles, and uncovered services, individuals are going to see better health care and better economic outcomes. Medical, dental health, mental health, and vision services will be covered under the act, and payments to healthcare providers for all eligible services will be made from a single fund, the Ohio Health Care Fund. Under the plan, every Ohioan may receive full healthcare coverage, regardless of income or employment status, and may freely choose their own healthcare providers for services. As outpatient services to prescription drugs, medical supplies and medical transportation without costly co-payments and deductibles. There will be also no exclusion for pre-existing conditions. The health care plan will be administered by the Ohio Healthcare Agency under the direction of the Ohio Healthcare Board. The board will consist of two elected representatives from seven regions across the state and the director of the Ohio Healthcare Agency. The board will negotiate and set prices for healthcare services. Negotiate, this is our most powerful point. Establish proof of residency standards, provide identification for individuals to establish eligibility for services and seek all necessary waivers, exemptions, agreements, or legislation to allow various federal and state health care payments to be made to the Ohio Health Care Agency. Additionally, the Ohio Health Security Act will remove a lot of the red tape currently allowing executives to gouge our health care system. With lower overhead, better bargaining power, and de-emphasizing profit, the Ohio Health Security Act strengthens Ohio's economic and health outcomes. Finally, here are a few closing thoughts for the committee to ponder. Over 60% of American households that go bankrupt do so because of medical bills. 75% of that 60% had health insurance at started the bankruptcy illness. No one should have to mortgage their future in order to live. Americans are working harder and dying younger, draining our bank accounts and maxing out on credit cards to cover medical care along the way. The Ohio Health Security Act will save money for Ohioans. That is money that they can invest in their new leases on life, in their futures, in their families, in our great state. The United States has the highest medical costs in the world as a percentage of GDP and have significantly worse health outcomes than people in other rich countries. The United States is ranked 37th for efficiency, 31st for life expectancy. Infant mortality is 52% in the world, tied to Siberia. If Ohio was a country, Ohio's infant mortality would be 62nd in the world, tied with Lebanon. Our maternal mortality is 42nd in the world, just behind Pakistan. And if Ohio was a country, we would be tied with Latvia. Even as millions receive health care under the Affordable Care Act, millions more remain uncovered. The tax bill that canceled the ACA mandate will add 9 million more to our uninsured. At a point, we will be a population in the United States about the size of Canada that is uninsured. The Ohio Health Security Act guarantees health insurance, including dental.